Sarah, and I want to talk to you about my painting history and how I came to this form of painting, which is decorative painting with acrylics. And it started long, long time ago, 20 years ago to be precise, literally 20 years ago in 1996 when we moved into this neighborhood. My son was in kindergarten and another little boy that lived in this neighborhood was in kindergarten, and I met his mommy, and she was over one day and she saw these little magnets on my refrigerator, and these are just little wooden pieces that you get at Michael's, the little shapes. And I'd always loved crafting, making things and knitting, crocheting. I've always created in one form or another. And so I painted, actually this is Thumper from the Bambi books. I just used one of my kids' books and thought I could just do Thumper. So I didn't trace it or anything. I just kind of sketched it probably with a pencil and painted it to the best I could with acrylic craft paint. And then I think I even varnished it. I didn't even varnish these. Like, so this little teddy bear, I probably just saw in a coloring book as well and just painted him. And then I made this little heart, Sarah and Joe, and a little, you know, it's very primitive, very beginner. I had no, see, I think I even added this floating after, because I didn't varnish them, because I didn't even know about varnish. I did that after, but these are like 20 years old. So anyway, Ellen saw these on my refrigerator and introduced me to the world of decorative painting. I hope there's not too much glare, but this is literally one of my very first. I think I did sign it. Yeah, this I did in 96, 3/30/96. That's why I tell you guys to sign your pieces, because it's really fun to go back and look and see where you were at the time. So long story short, Ellen was involved in a group, a local chapter of the National Society of Decorative Painters. And we met once a month. So I joined up, and we met once a month in Ocean City, and we would paint a little project. Sometimes it would probably be an ornament. It would be an ornament at Christmas time. We did swaps too with ornaments. It would be anything. It could be anything. It could be a pen and ink piece. And a lot of times it was just people from the chapter that would teach the item. And I started teaching towards the end of my membership. I was definitely teaching. And we also brought in the big artists, the artists who were published in periodicals, because there was a lot of painting magazines out back then, and there still are. And maybe I'll list some of them in, there's Toll World. Here, hold on, I'm going to go get a couple. Okay, so I'm just going to set this aside for a second. So, like I said, I was a member. We would get the big brushes in, right? So those are people who are published in magazines. And this is one called Decorative Artist Workbook. And it is, I'm trying to see the date. This is from August 2000. And inside here, you'll get the patterns and all the directions to paint these projects. You get, what would this be called? Like a worksheet of how to do the strokes to complete the piece. And, you know, lots of good information. Not always things that I loved or wanted to paint. This one's called Decorative Woodcrafts. And this is by Better Homes and Gardens. And it may just be something that came out once in a while. But, you know, whenever I saw these, and this is back before the internet, guys, you got to remember, in 2096, we didn't have the internet the way we do now. There were no online classes, and I mean, this was the best, the next best thing besides going to a class. So see, you would have this is a very beginner, and I would look through here and see if there were things that I could teach to beginners. But these Santas, I mean, it's pretty beginner, pretty basic. Once you get into wet on wet, I wasn't really proficient at. I painted this. I painted this on, it wasn't on, this is a canvas placemat. But I painted a lot of these things. I really love this little angel. And I never made her, but boy, that would be a cute little project to do. I might have these wings. These are like rusty tin wings. But anyway, it's an art. I mean, it's pretty big. But so let's see. This one's called Paintworks. This is a fantastic one, and I don't even know if these are still in publication. But I subscribe to all of these magazines. So this one's going back to, I'm trying to find a date. I don't see it on here. It's got to have it. Anywho, but see, oop, there's my address. But the Christmas editions were awesome because it would have all the ornaments in here, all your Christmassy stuff. Like, see, this is actually painted on a terracotta pot and the terracotta dish thing that's behind it. And then she even painted the candle. Just a plate. There's fancy stuff and there's beginner stuff. So here's the Low Cornell brushes. These are Low Cornell. Anyway, I just did a brush review. But the Paintworks Christmas was a wonderful one. I looked forward to that. This one's just called Painting. Why doesn't it have the date? It must be inside. February 04. And this is Judy and Lynn. Judy Dipas and Lynn Deptula were, they're two of my favorites because of all the detail that they put into their pattern packets. I actually took a class with her too. Marie McNaughton, I went to a seminar with her. She had actually a very specific brush technique that she used, and I bought the brushes. Anywho, that's where I took all my inspiration. This is another Paintworks Christmas. Then, okay, so like I said, I started out doing it on my own. Ellen saw my pieces and said, hey, you like painting? Well, we're starting this chapter of the National Society of Decorative Painters. And this is the, let's see what year this is. This is November 05. And this is only, I think, quarterly it comes out. It wasn't monthly. I think, see how this says November, December? It may be bi-monthly, but it was, usually a pretty big name. Artists were in here, just lots of information. And another, if when you're a member, you had to be a member of the National Society of Decorative Painters when you're in a chapter, and you pay dues, and this is part of your dues. You get the magazine. I don't even know what else. I mean, you probably get, now you would get emails about everything and go to convention. I went to one national convention in Indianapolis. But I went to lots of other conventions. Here's Toll World Painting. Sorry. I subscribe to a lot of these magazines. But I had, there was one I wanted to show you from NET. This is a convention, the New England Traditions Presents an Autumn Palette. I went to this convention. This is in October 02, and I went to NET like three times, I think. It's in Providence, Rhode Island, and Providence is really cute little town. It was very convenient because the convention center hosts the convention, obviously, and there's a trade show, all the classes are in the building, and I just stayed across the street at the Marriott. I think the convention centers are attached to a hotel a lot of times, but we are Marriott members, so we had points and stuff, and I could stay at the courthouse, or I could stay at a lot of different, most cities have somewhere you can stay that's close to the convention center, so that's what I would do. And it's, I think, a 5-hour drive to Providence for me, I think. And it's not far. Like, you would go 2.5, stop for lunch, and go 2.5, and you're there. So it wasn't bad. And a lot of times people room together to save money. Anyway, this is everyone's there. All the teachers come into the convention, well, a lot do. And then you pick and choose what classes you want to take. Just like, well, not just like, because I think when I did Polymer Clay Adventure, all the classes are included. All the teachers, everyone takes all the same teachers. But when you go to these, you can pick and choose who you want to take and how many days you want to go. So it's usually from like Thursday, sometimes Thursday night through Sunday. And so much fun, you guys. Like, really, I miss it so much. And these still exist. There's still one they do every year in Las Vegas that I've never been to, called Hoot. Heart of Ohio Tollers does that one. I'm pretty sure Net is still doing it. National is going to be in Florida, I think, next year. I'm not sure. It's still going on. But after 20 years, basically, of painting, I kind of had been there, done that. And it really hit me after my mom passed away. When she got sick, I needed to have things that I could bring with me, take to the hospital, or just go over her house and kind of when I was just sitting with her, that I could keep busy doing. So I started crocheting again. I did plastic canvas and things that I could just take in a little tote, and got away from the painting a little bit. I can't think of when I actually got away from it. I think the chapter kind of got been there, done that for me. I thought I wasn't really learning anything anymore. And for me, sometimes, obviously, as you know from my channel, I'm just going to put these in the shot, that I get bored. I feel like I like to learn new things. That is where I feel inspired. And so when decorative painting wasn't doing that for me anymore, I found YouTube. Luckily, it was a time in which technology was at my fingertips, and I could search, and I just start, when I saw something, Pinterest came along, all those things, and when I saw something that interests me, I would Google it and just follow through and go to the web page and just search it out and try it. And then, of course, I found YouTube, and it opens up a whole new world of crafting. So that's what I did for 3 years. For 3 years, while I was on YouTube, I pretty much made everything in the kitchen sink. Anything that was, you know, I tried paper crafting, resin for a little bit. I love beading, and, you know, I mean, you know that story. But what I'm getting at is, I feel like decorative painting is coming back around, and you know how that happens. It's like what old is new. What goes around comes around, right? And a lot of these artists are getting into the mixed media world. And it was the same way with oil painters. When acrylic painting, this form of painting, came along, oil painters wanted to get involved. Oils are, I don't know much about them, but they used a lot of toxic, you know, you had to use, I don't even know what they're called. I'm sorry, I'm not thinking, my words aren't coming, but you know what I mean? Like, oils don't dry, so you can keep playing with them, and to clean, everything's like turpentine and stuff like that. So acrylics are water-based, and so all of that went away, and a lot of the artists who did oils wanted to play with acrylics and see what they could make happen with that. That's where the wet-on-wet techniques are from, and I just didn't learn them. I was doing this. By the time I got involved with acrylic paint, it was base coat, highlight, shade, and, you know, stuff like that. You weren't wet on wet as much. A lot of the different classes I took, yes, we did do some of that. But I am very proficient in the way that I teach and paint, which is to base coat everything down, add your shading and highlighting, and then add your details. So, I was just going to show. So, for you beginners, this is what I wanted to say. You gotta start somewhere. And if it's going to AC Moore and buying these little ornament things, paint them. Just start. Don't be afraid. This is 49 cents. And I think they're even cheaper. You can get them, you know, I mean, I don't know. Maybe not. This was 20 years ago. I had my husband cut me these out of wood. You get a piece of wood and you just cut it into a shape and paint it. I think YouTube is a great way to start. Just find somebody that you like, their techniques, you feel comfortable, and just do it. Just start. I did a little paint brush review. I've done other paint brush videos about what I feel like are good brushes to start with. You need some paint, and I just would buy the cheap acrylic paints. They're fantastic. DecoArt is a great paint. They hold up for years. Like I was going to show you this, I painted, this was one of my very first big deal classes that I took. This was a class with Arlene Newman, and she's an artist who paints near me. She teaches in her home. This was from 96, and it was a big deal. I did it. I mean, it's not perfect. I see a lot of, you know, I can see, I was telling you guys, well, I tell you in the angel video I do, to erase your tracing lines, and I can see my tracing lines here that I didn't erase. Once you paint over them, you can't get them off. What else? I mean, my floats, look, they're not, they're chunky, they're just on the edge of the flowers, but guess what? When you hang this on the wall, it looks great. It looks beautiful. And, you know, I was very proud of it. And it's, I could do better now, yes. But it's still, I got my shines on here. We did flip floats. We did so much. And I was a beginner. I was a beginner. I was not, like, I hadn't painted very much at all. I just did what she said. I just followed along to the best that I could do. And I mean, it is what it is. So you can see the tracing lines. I can. I was gonna say I have this other one. I know for a fact there's no date on this one. This was a class that I took, and her name was Vicki Schwartz. She was a woman who taught in her home again, and I was lucky enough that we did have, wall is about an hour from me, and then Vicki lives more toward, hers was about a half an hour from me, and I painted with her for years. She taught classes in her home, and she chose what she wanted to teach. She was very country, so we painted a lot of country stuff. But I mean, this is basic, but you can tell my floats, look, I'll show you. Now a float is when you take a brush and you're gonna graduate the color from dark to light to water. And so that's what this should be here. And it really kind of just looks like a stripe there. You see what I'm saying? But it should be much more graduated. But this was a beginner piece, and I did it. I just did what she said. I did my floats, and if they look stripey, they look stripey. And you know, I really was happy with it. My favorite thing though is doing all these details. Like once you start to add the lines, and I mean my line work was really good. Like I like that, and I may have a little bit of a natural tendency toward that, and it's easier for me, but these are learnable skills. It's all teachable and learnable techniques. There's nothing here that, you know, and it's a traced pattern. I didn't have to think about, that's what I loved about this type, this style of painting is, you don't, I'm using someone, and I don't know who the artist is. I'm sorry, I don't remember who created this design, but they literally tell you what color to shade with, how to do the technique. So float here, dry brush there. You know, and it's really, it takes the, you don't have to think about it. Just try the technique. Try to apply the technique that, they're teaching. Now, this is another Arlene Newman, and I know that I painted this. Oh, that's a piece of something fell out of that. I think, and I'm not positive, this is probably Arlene's piece. She designed, we usually took what she designed. So this is probably Arlene. I was going to say, because Debbie Cole is a big fur person. She makes a lot of bears and things like that. But I was a very beginner painter when I did this. Very beginner. And I mean, you can paint a star and you can paint words, stripes, but all this teddy bear cushy stuff, the fur, was a technique. And I used the brush. There are specific brushes. I probably used a deer foot, and I don't even know if I have one out, because it's specialized to do, let's see. I don't think I have a deer foot out here, but they're awesome. Like, if you love to paint critters, you're going to want to get a deer foot or some other type of stippling brush. It's for stippling. I do not see it, but like, just, I'm just looking over here in my specialty brushes. This brush, I think it's called a Wave. Black Gold Dynasty, I think it's a Wave. And if you look at that, it has little notches cut in the bristle. And so you could do hair with that if you get up on the, so they create brushes to do these techniques with. The people who say they do hair all the time, and instead of making one strand at a time, they created a brush for them. So, anywho, all of this is absolutely possible. Just try it. All you have to do is, like I said, get a piece of wood. Just use your art journal. Get a pattern and start working. Now, these are some of my favorites would be, this is Renee Mullins, and I painted her stuff last year. I love Judy Dipehouse and Linda Ptula, and I'm pretty, this is Judy Dipehouse. Their instructions are just so clear. I mean, covered with paint at the moment. They give you all your supplies, and a lot of times they give you line drawings and shading, but painting terms, a picture. Their books are even better. See, I don't have it, but just try it. Don't be afraid to just try it. And that's what I'm hoping to do. Next month, I think, is National Painting Month. I'm going to look into that some more. And I've already, I said, I have, this is another little, I think we did this at Chapter. And I've painted it so many times. I got stickles on there, I can see. Super simple. The background technique, this is from 04, but it's a little pencil pad holder, right? And I lost my train of thought. But I'm trying to do these free patterns for you guys and walk you through it from start to finish in real time. So that you, and I, if I make a mistake, you see my mistake, you see how I correct it, and you come away with this cute little ornament, and or whatever we're gonna do. I think I'm gonna do the tote. I'm gonna try and do a couple things next month. I've already filmed these ornaments. They're in the can, and I have a couple. I want to get working on the art doll. I have the dolls. The wood is all cut. I have to load up my art, my Etsy store, but I have to just, really, there's nothing. I just have to, oh, I want to work on the PDF file that you are going to be able to access to get the pattern. That's what I need to do. But in the meantime, you know, I get caught up in all the other stuff I want to do. So I hope that helped. And listen, nobody, if you don't like it, throw it away. Don't worry about it. It's not like, you know, that's why I say use your art journal. And when I've done, like I did this piece in my art journal, I haven't worked in here in a long time. This one. This is a very, it was the angel. There's an angel in here that really, I mean, this was just painting, just decorative painting. I sketched her out. And then I'm trying to do faces, and I've never done faces, really. I mean, that's something I've never really done. I've never done faces. So I took Lifebook this year. That's an online seminar that lasts all year long. And Tamara Laporte, she loves to paint faces and girls, and so I just started it, and I just started trying, and I wanted to see how I could use floating and the way that I paint to do a little face. So I just made this angel, but I used stenciling. I stenciled some words on her wings, and I stenciled all these stars. And I love using metallic paint, because that's what's happening, is the mixed media part of it is so cool now. It's making it exciting for me again. It's not the same old, same old. All the sprays and different things. So that's why this artist here, Deb Antonik, and I wish I heard someone say her name so that I would know how to pronounce it, but she's teaching a class in Canada right now, because I'm on her Facebook page, and they are definitely geared toward mixed media. The backgrounds are all mixed media. She's adding little paper collage pieces into her work. So these wings were book pages, stuff like that. She's adding metal charms to the surface as well. It's just really bringing, taking decorative painting the next step. So get on board and see what's out there. Google it, you know, and see. Go get yourself a few basic supplies. Maybe, sorry, I thought my camera made a word. get yourself some color, just your basic color, your basic color palette. I'm not a big brush mixer or color mixer, but you can color mix and play. Because I just have paint. I've had paint for years, so I have all these, we're considered bottle babies. And I know I'm blathering on, but listen, my main point of this whole video is just try it. Don't be afraid. Start somewhere. Just slap some paint down, and before you know it, you're gonna have a cute little thing that you created. And it's your work. Yeah, you're using someone else's design, but pretty soon you can start to transform it into your own design. I mean, these aren't, you know, hard little patterns. You can tweak it and put your own little faces, or put a little doggy in her arms, or whatever, you know. But for me, this type of painting was so easy. I didn't have to think, and I just did what they told me to do, and that's why I loved it so much. So I hope that wasn't too much, and I hope that you'll try it. All right, you guys, thanks for watching.